All right, I'm going to start by creating a new component using Angular CLI. So let's go to the terminal, ng, g, what's next? C for component, and then favorite is the name of our component. Beautiful. Now let's go to the template for this component, that is favorite.component.html. So favorite.html. Okay, I'm going to delete this markup and render a simple star icon using Bootstrap. So a span element. And here I'm going to add a couple of classes. One is glyph icon, and the other is glyph icon-star. For now, I just want to render a static star icon. I don't worry about implementing any behavior here. I just want to make sure everything works up to this point. So now let's go to app.html and use our new component. So I'm going to delete all this markup and add app-favorite, which is the selector for this new component. Now here, app-dash is a little bit of noise. And because this is a small application, we're not going to use any third-party components. So the chances of this element clashing with another element defined somewhere else is very, very low. It's literally impossible. So I would prefer to make my code cleaner. Let's go to favorite.component.ts and change the selector here. Remove app dash. Make it simpler. Now back in the template for app.component, we can also simplify this and use favorite. That's better. Now let's test this up to this point. Back in the browser. Okay, we got a full star icon. Beautiful. Now we need to add behaviors to this. So back in our component, here we need to keep the state, the data behind this view. What is that data? That's the state of this icon. Or in other words, the object this favorite icon is for, whether that object is selected as favorite or not. So here I can declare a field, call it isFavorite, and we can initially set this to false, or we can use type annotation and set its type to Boolean. Again, it's going to be false, so it doesn't really matter which approach you choose. Now, in a real-world scenario, you want to get this state from the server. So we call a RESTful endpoint. We get a list of objects, like a list of Stack Overflow posts. And for each post, we know whether the current user has selected that post as favorite or not. But in this exercise, we don't want to worry about calling the server. So we're just going to focus on the user interface. So here's our field. We also need a method to toggle this field. So let's define a new method here. OnClick. So this is going to get called when the user clicks this icon. And here we simply set this that is favorite to not this that is favorite. So we're simply toggling this field. If it's true, it becomes false. And if it's false, it becomes true. Now let's go back to our template. So all icons should have this glyph icon class. But this second class, we want to render this dynamically based on the state of the component. So I'm going to delete this here and also break this into multiple lines so we can see more clearly. Now to add additional classes, I'm going to use class binding. So square brackets, class dot glyph icon dash star. We want to render this only if isFavorite is true. So we can bind this to isFavorite field. Okay. Now similarly, I'm going to apply another class binding here. So class.glyph icon, but this time dash star dash empty. And we want to render this class only if isFavorite is false. So we can bind this to isFavorite, but apply the not operator here. So when this expression evaluates to true, which means when isFavorite is false, then we're going to get this empty star icon. Okay. Now finally, we're going to handle the click event. And here we simply call onClick method. Let's test this. So back in the browser. So our star is initially empty. If we click it, it becomes full. If we click again, it becomes empty. I hope your solution was the same. If not, As long as it works and it's clean, that's perfectly fine.